A very good morning, everybody. Rajni from Sashakt Empowering Lives. Okay, so another booklet in the series of booklets. Yeah, up until now we had been doing books on basic English reading, we had been doing books on Hindi reading, mathematics, grammar. Now this is a booklet on language development at the inferential level. Okay, so basically language development, there is another booklet coming in which is for the tangible, but that is still in the process. So the inferential level where the child has to think. So if you are a parent of a child who will be able to answer all the what, where, who, you know, all of those, even when questions, will be able to look at a book and give you in, you know, information. Looking at the book, give you information on things which are very obvious and very in the face. But at the same time, if you would ask a question where the child has to use a little bit of thinking. So typically we see that around, you know, a grade 4, 5, when we have the and beyond. The textbooks, the English textbooks, where a story is written and we say my child can understand what, when, where, who, can ask questions, but this bigger story, and the child is not able to make the mental construct, is not able to understand that, oh, this is not written, but okay. So they are able to connect the dots and think and imagine certain things. For example, if it is written that, you know, Ravi was driving very fast, he looked at his watch, he was very upset, he increased the speed, he did not want to have his wife angry on his special day. It was his anniversary and it was already 8 o'clock. And the kid reads that passage, but for the kid to understand that Ravi got late because Ravi must have had some work at the office, he started late from the office, because all of that is not written. All of that is required to be assumed, okay, understood. Excuse me. And when that kind of understanding is not existent, then for the child to connect the dots that why is he rushing, yeah, and why does he not want his wife to be angry, what does it mean to have a special day, so all of those questions and stuff like that. And then we say my child can read very well, but when it comes to understanding the passage that's given in the textbook, he or she will not be able to narrate the story, only the main basic things. So this is where this booklet on inferential thinking development comes in handy. This booklet is 40 pages of sheer incidents of information that, okay, if this happened, now like I'll read a question to you so that you get an idea. Okay, so this has three sections. Section 1, simplest. Section 2, slightly complex. And section 3, very complex. Okay, so for all children who are going to mainstream classrooms, who are in, grade 5, 6, 4, 5, 6 and beyond, and struggling with the big textbooks, this book will come in hugely handy because it will help build the mental imaging, which will help them with their school syllabus also. So for example, from the very first page, section A, part 1. So I'm reading the question. Veer is angry. Jay ate his ice cream. I'm all the time about my kids, so I'm naming my kids only in questions also. But these are real life situations. Jay did not apologize. So okay, I'll repeat the question because I have a tendency of getting distracted. Veer is angry, Jay ate his ice cream. Jay did not apologize. Now Veer will get another ice cream and not share it with Jay. Yeah? So this is section 1 and the first question, very simple. So why do you think Veer will not share ice cream with Jay? So, because it's the very simple thing that majority of kids will say, because Jay ate his ice cream. So then our job is to say, so what? So Veer felt bad. So why? Because it was Veer's ice cream. Veer had to eat it, but Jay ate it. And then Jay did not even say sorry. Now Veer will get ice cream and not share with Jay. So like this, okay, going forward. Okay, policeman is shouting on a man. Man is not wearing helmet. Man is on a motorcycle. Policeman will take away the man's motorcycle. Man is upset. He says sorry. Policeman says no. If you break rules, you get punished. Why should the man get punished? What rule has he broken? Now, a question like this is going to be helping the kid develop the understanding and using the various things. So if he's learned something in a road safety lesson in EVS, so integrating all the learning and saying he is driving without a helmet, that is something for which he will have a fine. That is breaking a rule. Okay, the word coming to me was that is a punishable offense. Now that's too big for the kids, so I stopped and I thought, let me pick up a smaller word. So if children can do that is a punishable offense, yeah, for the 8th graders, 9th graders, great. For children who can't do that much language, then that is breaking a rule. Okay, he is, or don't even say that is. So he is breaking a rule. He is driving without helmet. So we give proper language to the kids. Now how to use this book is, we are not expecting the kid to read all the matter, then process it, then come back, because we are also looking at mental image formation. So we will read it for the kid and say, okay, tell me, what do you think? And in the process, if the kid doesn't know a concept from real life, we will explain. If the kid knows the concept but doesn't know how to put it in words, that sharpens their language skills. So this was your very simple level one. Then there is section B. Section B. Mummy opened the fridge. She took out an apple. She was upset to look at it. She threw it in the bin. She scolded kids. Why don't you eat fruits? They get wasted. What could have happened? What is it that the kids did because of which she had to throw it in the bin? Now here a lot of thinking will be required for the kid. So basically the kid has to put their head into stuff which is not written. The apple has got rotten. Apple was in the fridge for 10 days. Nobody ate the apple. It got rotten. Mummy had to throw it. Why is mummy angry if she has to throw it? Because mummy went to market to get it. Mummy spent money to get it. Now it is rotten. It is wasted. Lots of concepts, lots of language. Then there is section C. Section C, of course, with the progression slightly tougher. Manisha sees chips and takes it. Okay. Harsh and Manisha are having lunch in the cafeteria. Okay, so if your kid is not reading cafeteria, you can say canteen. Okay. Harsh's dad packed good lunch for him. Manisha sees chips in Harsh's lunchbox and takes it from his lunchbox. Jaya Miss sees Manisha eating from Harsh's lunchbox and says, "Eat your own lunch." Now then you have a series of questions. So the kid has to imagine, understand. Many a times what happens is that in the classrooms, our children doing the same thing. They like something in somebody's tiffin and they just take it away and they eat it without realizing that it is not the right thing to do. So somewhere the intangible or the inferential thinking deficits also lead to social communication deficits and social etiquettes, lack of social etiquettes. So now the questions like, when teacher says eat your own lunch, why teacher has to say this to Manisha? Oh, to Manisha, yes. what wrong has Manisha done? Should she have done this? So understanding the language, putting it in as many words, giving it in as many words back, having an understanding and awareness that, okay, it's not written, but this is what it is. Like in one of my inferential thinking classes, I asked a kid that if if Papa has to go out of station for 10 days, will he take a taxi or will he take his own car to the airport? And why? And kids could not answer. It was very simple, thought process that if my daddy will take a taxi, only then he can, at the airport, just get dropped and take the flight and come back 10 days later. Okay. If he takes his own car, where will he park his car for 10 days? Yeah. And I said specifically, Papa is going to drive the car. No one is going with him. Should he be driving the car or should he be taking the taxi? And children as old as 10 years of age could not answer that question because mental imaging was missing. So that inspired me to also create, along with the inferential building classes that I do, that also for parents to, so that the books can reach far and wide. This has, each section has good about 30 odd questions and a total of 40 pages of just pure instances. This happened and that happened, and then how should he have behaved, how should she have behaved, what wrong they did, if you were in place of this person, what would you do? So our expectation is not from the kid to read one full thing, comprehend. We can read and comprehend and ask the kid. If the kid can read and comprehend, great. But otherwise, we can read and comprehend and say, so what wrong did the child do? So this is the inferential textbook, booklet to help children develop thinking and reasoning skills. So this booklet is out and I got limited copies. So this video goes out for parents whose kids are presently at this level and struggling, that please go ahead and book your copies soon. This is 500 each booklet. I will also give a soft copy in case you happen to for some reason you ruin it or something, so you can take a print again. And keep practicing with the kid until the kid has that awareness to be able to answer the questions where everything is not written and mentioned. And so, like, a lot of people tell me, wow, it is so good, Jay is doing so much. And thank you, God, for everything, and thank you for all the good wishes and warm wishes and all the blessings I get from all of my student community. But the fact is, if you want to fill a big tanker, every drop of water counts. We have to look at it in a pinpointed, focused way, with proper focus, that where is my kid lacking? And a major part to any kid's lacking is in the area of inferential thinking. So on that note, this book comes from my side as a humble attempt to help anybody who's struggling with inferential thinking and mental image formation. Okay, so these are limited copies. You can order these copies on 7021777777. Yeah, and that's it. It will be 500 plus the shipping charges. May each kid win.